Tucson, Arizona, Mr. Bobby Ferraro. Introducing the principals. First of all, in the red corner, wearing the blue trunks with the gold trim, he weighed in at 228.5 pounds, fighting out of Houston, Texas, with a professional record of 17 wins, 7 losses, 1 draw, 8 big knockouts, Everett Bigfoot Martin. His opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the white trunks with the red and blue trim, weighed in at 256 pounds. From Marshall, Texas, with a professional record of 63 wins, 2 losses, 60 big knockouts, ranked number 12 in the world, and he is the former heavyweight champion of the world, George Foreman.
Chief Second, let's go. Okay, you both had your instructions. You know the rules. I want you to abide by them. I want a clean fight. I want a safe fight. When I ask you to break, I want clean breaks. I don't want no pawing, no hitting behind the head, rapid punching, and no punching in the back. When I ask for a break, I want a clean break. Shake hands. Good luck to both of you.
George Foreman intently listening to the referee, Bobby Ferrara, for the instructions. He is going up against the heaviest opponent that he has faced. Previously, it was Dwight Cowie and Tom Trim. Both were 228. Cowie also fought this man, Everett Martin, back in May and beat him in 10 rounds, while George Foreman, with a TK over Cowie, the former light heavyweight and cruiserweight champion, in 7.
George Foreman has not even broken a sweat yet. Martin, nice and loosened up. He's got a sweat going, a little bit of bead.
George Foreman will work the sweat up very quickly. It is getting hotter and hotter in this arena here in Tucson. It was 107 degrees in the shade this afternoon. What kind of chance does Martin have? Where does he have a chance to pull off the upset?
Pulling him off on the side in the corner, I did get a fight plan from him. He said he was going to try to take the strength away from Foreman, shut his power away by using the angles. And he was rather vague in his fight plan. He had to sit there and think about it for a minute. You better know your fight plan. The day before the fight, if you don't know it, I'm afraid you may not do it.
Well, all day yesterday he was saying it was a secret. Sometimes that means a fighter just doesn't have a clue what he's going to do. Martin, soft hitter, Sean, but shows a lot of movement.
Soft hitter, and he moves his head quite well, keeps his hands up high, but we're going to see how much this heavier weight has slowed him down.
And he's trying to work inside. He certainly is not going to beat George Foreman from the outside. First minute of action. It is scheduled for 10. George, before the fight, saying this could be a distance fight. He's sounding as if he wanted a workout. He has gone the distance just 4 times in his career in 65 fights.
And Foreman is extremely strong. Martin does not want to stand in there and wrestle with this big guy.
Last time Foreman went the distance, 12 years ago, his final fight when he lost in 12 to Jimmy Young in 1977. Foreman digging in. No question, Foreman has the punch as he gets Martin to the side. And Martin continues to stand in and hold and get right up chest to chest with Foreman.
A lot of heavyweights have been successful staying on the inside against the other heavyweights. But where they have problems with Foreman is he's got some amazing uppercuts that rip off your head. You lean in like that, he brings those uppercuts on the inside. I've seen a couple of them already in this first round.
Everett Martin started his professional career as a light heavyweight. He won 13 of his first 14 fights, then started losing weight, drifting down to the super middleweight division, and then coming back up again. He has beaten Bert Cooper in 10, then he lost in 7 to Johnny DePoy, and then his last fight losing to Cowie.
And this could be the way that he's trying to take the power away from Foreman. He's trying to back up Foreman now. In my opinion, opinion, that's a mistake because of the strength of Foreman. Foreman's got fantastic balance, too.
And Foreman just doing pushing away as he did with Joe Frazier. And that's why George Foreman feels he could beat the Mike Tyson, because he is the smaller, the solid build. Here's a simulated Tyson build to a certain extent. The small, solid guy in Everett Martin. We'll talk more about that when we return. But first, here's a word from our local cable systems. We're in Tucson tonight, but Sean, you're commenting, you think that George may be somewhere else.
He doesn't have that concentration, the eye of the tiger that I was talking about. One of the things that people are looking for when they see him fight is how serious he is about the fight. It appeared, though, in that first round, he was not that concerned with Everett Martin, but he better be.
Martin has been down just once in his career, and that is the loss to Johnny DePoy. Now Martin trying to spin and turn. He knows the better chance he has, the longer this one goes. He would like to see how Foreman reacts going longer and longer. That is a 10-round fight for Foreman. Last time was 12 years ago that he was forced to go at least 10. And now George digging in.
Martin landed a sneaky left hook, and I think it made Foreman mad.
Second round action. George Foreman and Everett Bigfoot Martin. How do they get the nickname? You take a look at his feet, not too big. As a matter of fact, they're just size 9. But when he was a youngster, he just hated to wear shoes. And the comment was, put some shoes on those big feet.
Oh, nice right hand by Martin. Martin sneaky with his punches. He snuck that right hand out close to Foreman and nailed him with it.
Martin asked what was his best punch, his strongest hand. He said both. That was a lesson from Sugar Ray Robinson, his idol. And the right by Foreman turns the head of Everett Martin.
My mother and I were arguing at the kitchen table for about an hour and a half the other day about Foreman's comeback. And she says that Foreman does what no other fighter does. The strength, the balance, he pushes back Everett Martin. If he does that with Tyson, Tyson's never seen that before. Nice left hook. Snuck it in from Foreman. Tyson's never seen that before. How would he react to it? Good question. Nobody knows how he would react. We know how Joe Frazier reacted to it. It took the power away from Frazier.
That was 16 years ago. George Foreman, by the way, in that fight against Frazier in Kingston, weighed 217 and a half pounds. And then when he lost the heavyweight title to Ali in 74, in Zaire, he was 220 pounds.
And talking about his weight, he says, come on, let's get some real heavyweight champions, some big men. Now the heavyweight champion, 216, Mike Tyson, he's a small guy. He wants to see a big guy in that title over.
And the second round ends with a flurry. Round number three, George Foreman in the white, and in the blue is Everett Bigfoot Martin. George Foreman, who has been talking to the Evander Holyfield camp as he takes an uppercut. Holyfield trainer Lou Duva is watching on from Virginia Beach, where right now he's training Pernell Whitaker for an August fight with Jose Luis Ramirez, and we are hoping to hook up with Lou via the phone and talk to him at the conclusion of this fight. Get his reaction on Foreman and also the possible Holyfield matchup. Right now, Everett Bigfoot Martin sticking his big fists in the face of Foreman, who is ranked number 12 by the WBC.
And he's using that big fist with the speed. And he's catching Foreman. Foreman, between rounds, standing up in the corner and with his legs crossed, looked as though he's not concerned at all with what's going on inside the ropes. Again, the eye of the tiger. Use every second to your advantage when you're inside those ropes. You've got a minute between rounds to sit down. Sit down, catch your breath. Take your time. Relax a little bit. Get some instructions. Get ready for the next round.
A year ago, George down to 235, and there is the big shot of the night by Foreman, going to work on Martin, just spinning him around. And Foreman now showing the heavy lumber and the crowd coming alive, and this is exciting Foreman even more.
But Martin taking the punches and punching back. He's still trying to get those angles that I talked about. Look at him moving around, trying to get behind Foreman.
Another big wave by Big George.
Now, look at those shots. What Martin wants to do is have George expend some of that energy. Make him throw those big shots, but make him miss. Martin didn't want to get hit by him. Can't blame him.
Under a minute to go. George Foreman has not been touched, certainly not been hurt. And Martin at this point being wearied down as he has been feeling some terrific blows from Foreman.
And it also is taking a lot of energy out of him to wrestle in there with Foreman. Foreman getting the better of him because he's the bigger man. Nice double left hook by Foreman. He shifted all of his weight over to that left side. What balance George Foreman has got.
Well, he is certainly solidly anchored on the canvas. We were talking about the ropes earlier, ropes that favor Foreman, but he has been in the middle of the ring throughout this fight.
Well, this ring also would favor Foreman. It is a puncher's ring.
And very loose ropes.
Heavy mat underneath this canvas, the loose ropes. Foreman could even lean back over the top of them. Edward Martin can't because he's not as tall as Foreman. Foreman 6'3", Martin at 5'11".
While in Tucson, hotel accommodations provided by Ramada Inn, located in downtown Tucson. It provides some of the finest hotel accommodations in the old Pueblo. Ramada Inn of Tucson. Most consecutive knockouts for a heavyweight champ. George Foreman ranks right up there behind the great John L. Sullivan. Foreman's 24 in a row started with a first-round knockout over Rufus Brazell in 1970 and ran all the way through 1973 against Ken Norton, the heavyweight title. It was snapped in Zaire by Muhammad Ali. And right now, Foreman in his second career has strung together 18 straight KOs and looks for number 19 tonight against Everett Martin. But George Foreman in the first three rounds, Sean, now has worked up that sweat.
Well, it's been all Foreman this first three rounds. He's taken some shots, though. Martin wanted to get past this third round, get into the fourth round, make Foreman work a little bit, get loosened up, take Foreman into a later round.
George Foreman, who is calling for Mike Tyson. Our telephone poll is going on right now. We'll give you a tabulation at the end of tonight's telecast. But in actuality, in the comeback, George really hasn't faced a heavyweight that you would really put in the top 20 or 30, maybe even 40.
Exactly, but what really worries me about George Foreman,
oh,
is he gets hit too much.
And Martin comes back with a right.
And he lands a good left uppercut.
Martin, in his career, has shown he can take a punch. He has been put down only once. Tell me a little bit about Everett Martin, who during his pro career has fought at times as a super middleweight. One of his losses, a matter of fact, the 12-round defeat at the hands of Vincent Boulware. But now fighting at 228 and a half. You would think 228 is a solid heavyweight, but he is really a cruiserweight blown up. What does that mean?
Exactly. He's got most of his weight around the midsection. He should be a middleweight because it's all around the middle.
And so should George.
He is
super middleweight.
He is a ballooned up. He is carried some of that speed with him, though, in this heavyweight division.
One thing, though, he's not used to is getting those kind of shots from Foreman.
From heavyweights. Now he's getting hit a lot.
Early in his comeback, George looked kind of disinterested in the ring, going through the motion. It was a man versus boys. But the Cooper fight, a little more focus. Here you thought a little concentration in the early rounds.
Yes, but now he's loosened up, he's broken a sweat, and it seems like now he's got more concentration. He's got his weight going forward, he's on his toes. But he still gets hit way too much. Look at that right hand.
And the questions with the Holyfield or a Tyson. You know Foreman's going to get hit even more.
Well, when he gets hit with one, by those two fighters, he'll be hit with four. And it's the conglomerate of punches that put the guy down and out in most cases.
Under 30 seconds left in round number four.
There's a push from Foreman trying to keep Martin off balance, keep him backing up. Trying to go away from that power, and also you get him out on the end of your punch. 90% of the power on the punch, that last 6 inches.
So Everett Martin so far has gone four. And getting ready for number five.
Nice combination by George Foreman. He threw the 1-2, and then he brought the left uppercut. Remember, we talked about his uppercuts and how dangerous they were.
This is round number five. The longest anyone has gone against George Foreman in the comeback was Dwight Cowley, and that was 7 rounds. Foreman says he wants to be big. He's never fast, never will be, so he's trying to turn big into an advantage.
And that right hand rocked Foreman. When Foreman gets hit, and a lot of punchers are this way, they have the big heavy hands, they commit themselves when they throw those punches. They move in with it. And unfortunately, a lot of times, they get hit solidly. A lot of the guys who have little punch use their movement well. And they go away from the punch, taking the power away.
Now remember, the last fight for Foreman was a defeat, only his second. He's lost just to Jimmy Young and Muhammad Ali. And in that fight against Jimmy Young, he was dehydrated, he was taking the distance, and went in against a guy who moved around. Same circumstances tonight.
And this is what kind of fighter that George Foreman does not want to face, a guy who moves side to side like Everett Martin's doing.
Fifth round action.
Oh, nice 1-2 combination. Oh, those hurt. Again, the big right hand from Foreman. He throws that right hand straight, and he also throws it as a sweeping hook, a right cross hook. Foreman carrying that left hand down below his waist. Dangerous.
There's the jab. Early in his comeback, Sean, Foreman was winning fights on jabs alone. But that was more a reflection on the opponents. Down to 30 seconds in the fifth round.
George Foreman came to my home when I was living in Oklahoma City one time, stayed with me and my family in our home before his fight in Oklahoma City against Lou Bailey. And when he stayed there, I noticed one thing about him. He always read comic books, never read books, magazines about the fight or newspaper articles about the fight. He's the one who taught me not to listen to the press. He never listens to the negative publicity, doesn't read a newspaper article, doesn't even like to watch boxing.
Foreman likes to have those boxing people in his corner. Shives, also Archie Moore is over there in his corner. As we have talked about before, Archie gives him lots of inspiration. Archie's been down the path before, knows how to make a comeback at a late age.
Well, he held on to the light heavyweight championship at, what, 48, 49 years of age. Foreman 41, the Geritol Kid. Richard Woodbury, who wrote the article in Time magazine, that calls George a middle-aged Rocky. Sixth round, Everett Bigfoot Martin hanging in there.
And Martin just stumbled. I don't quite know why, but he may be hurt here.
Coming back, shooting the right at Foreman was Martin. George said before the fight he felt this had the possibility of going the distance. He wouldn't mind it, looking for the workout. But what would be the reflection as far as the critics are concerned? With Everett Martin taking you the distance. What would happen against Holyfield and Tyson?
And Foreman may also be the one that's wanting a workout out here. He came into this ring tonight, not loosened up. He more or less coasted the first two rounds. Finally, in the third round, as Bobby Farrar, they're taping up the glove. The two are wrestling around a lot, and they've got tape on the glove. With that wrestling and also the sweat from their bodies getting underneath the tape, it'll sometimes come loose. The referee, Bobby Farrar, right on top of the action. What he does not want to happen is for that tape to catch in Foreman's eye. Nice right hand. What Martin has done too is he's stunned Foreman. He's shocked him with those punches like that right hand he just threw. He takes a right hand, but he comes back with a combination of his own. He perhaps realizes that every time Foreman commits, he leaves himself open.
George Foreman has been the busiest fighter around. This is his 19th fight in the past 28 months. He says he is now talking about elevating and stepping in against the likes of Holyfield. I even heard rumors about Michael Doakes. And we'll be talking to Lee Duvin. Trainer Holyfield coming off the convincing victory over Adelson Rodriguez last weekend. Into this fight.
Keeps trying to allow Martin to run into that uppercut. He'll throw a couple of jabs, allow for Martin to come in. When he does, he brings the left uppercut just off his rib. Watch, right on the inside. Let's see if he does it. Next round. A good round by Everett Martin. Some right hand work. He's found a home for that right hand. And also Foreman carrying that left hand low. He saw it and went after that opening that Foreman's showing him.
Only Dwight Cowie, who Everett Martin lost a 10-rounder to in May, has gone into a seventh round in the comeback of George Foreman. And here's Everett Martin, who spent at last minute in between rounds sitting on his stool and screaming into the air, psyching himself up.
He was screaming, "It's my time, Lord, it's my time." What he means is it's time to turn this fight around. Now, this is where he wants to get the aggressiveness in his attack.
Foreman has not been hurt. He has certainly been annoyed by Martin so far in the first six rounds.
He's been annoyed because Martin has popped him with sucker shots, shots that Foreman should not be getting hit with.
And over the comeback, you said, as far as Foreman's concerned, the one thing, the glaring error as far as he is concerned, is he has the tendency to get hit too much, especially with a faster opponent.
He gets hit way too much, and when he gets hit, he gets hit solid. It's not a rolling punch, a glancing blow. It's right on the chin like that shot right there. See, Foreman was moving in when he got hit with that punch. That adds a little bit more force to a punch, like two locomotives running straight on together, instead of a locomotive running into the back of another one, going away from it. You learn to roll with those punches. Something Foreman hasn't had to do, being that he's had 41 KOs out of his 60 in the first three rounds. We're inside the first three rounds.
Look at the awesome view of George Foreman with the 19-inch biceps bulging. Under a minute left in the seventh. And we may be seeing a rare distance fight in the career of George Foreman. 65 fights, he's heard that final bell only four times.
And Everett Martin has to be pleased with himself during this seventh round. He's still fighting, still throwing punches in there against the former heavyweight champion of the world. Ooh, nice right hand. He's taking right hands like that. Every time he gets hit, he fires back with a couple of punches. Look at all the pushing and shoving in there. Oh, and a big right hand by Foreman. But again, Martin comes back. Every time he gets hit, it's time to throw punches. Oh, nice right hand by Martin. Perhaps his best, two of them.
And Foreman came back with a right, and Mark now gaining some support from the crowd here in Tucson. He has completed seven rounds with three over the horizon. He will take George Foreman longer than any opponent in the Foreman comeback. USA is proud to present the best in international golf competition. The United States will meet a team of Europeans in the prestigious Ryder Cup from Belfry. Coverage begins September 22nd. The U.S. team consists of the top 10 PGA Tour players. Now, here's a look at the current top 10 American players. This is through the Anheuser-Busch Classic. The Ryder Cup will be seen right here on USA.
Everett Martin gaining in confidence also. He's in the seventh, into the seventh, the eighth round now. Finished seven. Takes a deep breath, still psyching himself up over in that corner. And George Foreman licking his lips.
Oh, a big left to start off the eighth round. Now we'll see how George Foreman reacts, having been taken this far into a fight. At this point, I don't think we've got to consider Georgia being behind in this fight. Certainly has the upper hand.
Look for fifth.
Yep. He's gone the distance four times, we've mentioned. The first time was his eighth fight against Roberto Davila back in 1969. That was an eight-rounder. In his 12th fight, Levi Forte took 10 rounds of Foreman. That was in 69. Then in his 16th fight, he went 10 rounds and beat Greg Peralta in 1970. And then his final fight. And there goes Martin. The second time in his career that he has hit the canvas.
Down he goes. He's shaking his head no. Looking over at Foreman. Foreman telling the referee, Bobby Ferrara, to stop the fight.
And Martin taking objection to that.
And Martin's saying, no way. He's got that middle game down.
Foreman opening up. Martin holding on.
Martin does not want to lose the concentration of this fight. And he does not want to get knocked out.
Halfway through the eighth.
What could it mean for his career if he could make the distance? Well, perhaps a lot of fights on the road fighting people who would like to fight Foreman. Maybe even fighters like Holyfield. Maybe anybody in that top 10. If they could knock him out, automatically people would be primed for a Foreman fight. Oh, and another right hand.
Everett Martin will not go away.
Lazy with that left hand, Foreman pays for it.
Martin trying to survive the knockdown here in the eighth. 50 seconds. Low blow by Martin, but and there's another one. But look how high the trunks are, George Foreman.
It is a low blow. The trunks are high, and underneath the trunks of Foreman, he's got on a foul-proof protector. It's padding underneath there. Martin still throwing punches. They're not hurting Foreman, but they are landing and they are scoring. You got to give him credit.
And the crowd cheering every score by Martin. We pause now for a word from our local cable systems. Onward to round number nine.
Everett Martin hit the canvas in that eighth round from that uppercut. Trying to get on the inside of the power of Foreman. Foreman caught him with that uppercut. Live action, ninth round. If you're told that in the corner, the old-time trainers tell you if you're going to take a break, take it this round and come on strong that final round.
Well, recently, Hector Camacho, a 10-round victory over his former sparring partner, Tommy Hanks. And after the fight, Camacho explaining it was just a workout. It was better than not fighting at all. He wanted to go 10. What do you think George Foreman's going to say?
He could be saying that, but I would have to wonder, you know, if he gets hit with shots like that, you know, against Everett Martin, who has little in the way of power, What's he going to do when he gets hit by someone with some power?
Someone like Holyfield or someone like Tyson. We have Lou Duva, Holyfield's trainer, watching on in Virginia Beach, and we hope we have a chance to get to Lou after this fight and get his reactions. The crowd cheering wildly for Foreman in the beginning of the fight, and now have shifted their support to Everett Martin.
Still cranking those punches is George Foreman. Every shot is a home run shot. Well, he's got the weight behind every punch, but he doesn't vary the intensity on those shots. If you get hit with one of them, you know you're hit.
Foreman was ending some of his earlier comeback fights with one of those shots. And Martin has sustained a handful and then some.
Oh, you heard that. Ouch. His body shot that head up.
Foreman has certainly thrown it all to try to end this fight. Slicing right.
Look at the right hand. Look at the hands of Foreman. He threw the right hand and he left his hands down by his waist. Nice rotation. The rotation in the shoulder. All that power is coming again from the shoulder as well as everything on that right side of the body. Nice. Left hook. Everett Martin pesky with his little punches. They're not hurting Foreman, but they are stunning him. They're shocking him that he's getting hit with those.
Everett Martin will be sleeping for days after this. Martin was down once in the fight. Inside 20 in round number 9. And for the first time in 12 years, George Foreman may be taken to the distance. We will be going into the 10th and final round. And the crowd responding for this 10th and final round. George Foreman really wanted nothing of touching gloves.
And when they were out there touching gloves, Everett Martin said, no, 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 you're not going to knock me out.
Martin upset in the 8th round when he went down, when he saw George Foreman motioning to the referee that he should stop the fight. So Martin even more determined to go the distance now with Foreman.
Foreman is getting tagged a lot in this fight. Martin's taking some shots, but he's retaliating every time he gets hit.
Has George Foreman ever been down? Ask Muhammad Ali and Jimmy Young and Ron Lyle. The answer is yes. All three. But the last time down was 12 years ago for Jimmy Young. It doesn't appear that he's in danger here tonight. He has put Martin down for only the second time in Bigfoot's career.
He's not really been in danger, but he may be exposing himself.
Everett could be going.
And Everett wisely ties up.
Standing here a little too far away from George. George able to make his extension. Will Everett Martin beat the clock and go the distance? Foreman pouring it on here in the 10th round. There's the time remaining. George peering in. He wants to take him out. And Martin right now just trying to dance through the 10th round with George looking to hold on.
Creepy crawling is Foreman. Look at him bend there over at the waist. He's trying to put those shoulders into the punches. Here he comes again. He rounds those shoulders to get him into the power of this punch. Looks as though he's trying to knock out Martin with that one punch. Not trying to put a conglomerate of punches together. And you got to give Everett Bigfoot Martin credit. He's taking some shots. Every time he gets hit, he fires back. He's still in there slugging it out in the 10th round.
get through the fight.
Only the fifth time in the career of George Foreman that he has been taken the distance in 66 fights. A moral victory for Everett Bigfoot Martin. We'll talk to George Foreman. We'll get the decision. Hopefully, we'll get the reaction of Lou Duva watching on in Virginia. And we'll give you our current tabulations in the George Foreman telephone poll. Welcome back to Tucson, where Everett Martin is celebrating. Said, I went the distance with a legend. I could fight anyone else. I proved myself, says Everett Martin, but he probably fell to his eighth defeat in 17 fights. As George Foreman just calmly, after the 10-round workout, awaiting the decision, which should hand him his 64th victory. He was never in trouble, just a pesky Martin was always in his face. Went down once, but survived. Bigfoot, who once fought as a super middleweight, came into this fight at 228 and a half. The heaviest fighter that Foreman has fought in this comeback, but will be the 19th victim unless there is some major surprise in the scoring. And now George playing to the crowd, starting the We Want Tyson chant. We're ready for the decision now. Let's go to Jack Bull.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a unanimous decision. I will read the scorecards as follows. Judge Greg's Q scores about 98-91. Judge Joe Garcia scores about 97-92. Judge Jerry Malt scores about 99-91. All for the winner, George Foreman.
Power punch. Everett Martin showing the last burst of strength, and that could have been the greatest accomplishment of the night, picking up George Foreman. The unanimous decision met by a smattering of boos. And the hand now was for Everett Martin, who stole the show as far as this crowd is concerned. And that streak of 18 straight knockouts for George Foreman in the comeback is stopped by a journeyman cruiserweight by the name of Everett Martin. Right now, Sean O'Grady in the ring with George Foreman.
George, when you fought Bert Cooper, I noticed how focused you were in that fight. Were you as focused in this fight tonight?
It's strange. This kid was taking a lot of unnecessary punishment. That's where you get a guy killed. This guy was hanging on, and just because of his nature, when I knocked him down, I asked the referee to stop it. He's going to get killed, so I just had mercy on the fella myself. I started hitting him with straight right hands rather than uppercut, trying to ruin his career. He'll make it somewhere. He got a 10-round decision with George Foreman, but it's a shame these 25-year-old guys have to pray to go 10 rounds with me, and I just can't. They're running and hiding and covering up. But basically, I want Tyson. You know, I need 10 rounds. I maybe go 10 rounds again, then fight Tyson, Holyfield, and then win the title.
George, let me ask you, did he ever hurt you? Because he caught you with some clean shots.
Well, I tried to make him put some punches in so I could catch him with body punches. I fooled him to throw a right hand, make him think it hurt so I can get inside and hurt him underneath his right hand. I did a couple times, but he has this great ability to recover from a punch. But he was able to run and take care of himself, cover up, which is what Mike Tyson better do, too. And I'm ready for the whole world. 10 rounds, 12 rounds, they can't stop me now. 25, 22. I'm 40 years old. I like to tell the world that I lived in the 40s. I lived in the 50s. I've lived in the 60s, the 70s. And I'm going to be fighting into the 90s. And, you'll see guys raising their hand just because they went 10 rounds with me. But all you 50-year-old guys out there, remember, we can do it. God bless.
George, well, let's go back down to Alabama. I'm not going to go and get this guy.
All right, then.